Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This week's video is actually going to be a DIY, and today I'm going to be making these marble clay bowls. If you did see my dorm tour, then you'll see that I mentioned the ones that I made previously in that video. Once I found out how easy these were to make, I was like, I need to show you guys this. I hope you guys enjoy this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I'd really appreciate it. And without further ado, let's get into this video. Okay guys, so to start out, what you're going to want to do is cut off about an inch of each color from each clay block that you have. And then for your main color, or the color that you want to show the most, you're going to want to cut off about 2 to 3 inches of that color. And in this case, I chose white because I wanted that one to show through. Next, you're going to start rolling each color into about a 5-inch snake, making sure that each color is pretty much the same in length. Now you're going to start twisting each color so that each color can start to become intertwined with one another. And you're really just going to keep doing this until you have no more colors to twist. And once you're there, you're just going to want to fold that in half and then start twisting again so the colors can mix more. And you're pretty much just going to be rolling and twisting until you get the desired color of your choice. And when you start to see a modeling effect, then you know you're exactly where you need to be. At that step, you're just going to get a rolling pin and roll that out. And to actually put the clay into the oven, you're going to need a small, I would say like an ice cream sized bowl, and just use that to cut out the shape with your knife of choice. And then you're going to put that in the oven for 15 minutes on 275 degrees Fahrenheit. Once the clay bowls are out of the oven and they're cooled down, you're going to take your Sculpey or whatever glaze that you're using and just put that over the clay so you can have like a nice sheen once it's done. Once the glaze dries, you can start going in with your gold around the rim. And in this case, I actually had to do 2 coats because I didn't like how you could see the clay underneath. And when that dries, you're pretty much done. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial and I'll see you on my next one. Baby, if I tell you what I want, don't call me crazy.